Hi everyone, Lisa Haven here. What happened in the year 1933 is happening again today. In 1933, Adolf Hitler took power and seized control over the press, limiting the free speech of those in Germany. And today, the exact same freedom of press is happening yet again. Independent news journalists are being silenced on big tech organization websites like Facebook and Twitter and PayPal. Not only that, but people have begun to self-censor themselves and begin to monitor what they can and cannot say online. We are absolutely under the control of a Nazi-style regime via the internet. Now, before I get into the report, I want to give a quick shout out to TrumpCoin2020.com. As you guys know, these coins are 0.999% silver, so they're a great bartering item, as well as an amazing memorial and a special gift for anyone this Christmas. I am going to be buying a ton of these at a good Christmas special, but it's TrumpCoin2020. 2020.com. It's got Trump's face and a lot of his accomplishments on back, but you can check that out in the description box below. All right, so back to the broadcast. What I want to do now is take you straight to the Holocaust Museum Encyclopedia so you can see some of the things that happened back in 1933 and how we have many similarities happening today. On the screen, you're going to see the press in the Third Reich. Then you're going to see establishing control of the press. I'm going to focus on that section. When Adolf Hitler took power in 1933, the Nazis controlled less than 3% of Germany's 4,700 papers. The elimination of German multi-party political system brought about the demise of hundreds of newspapers produced by outlawed political parties. Notice that they've outlawed political parties at this point, but it goes on. It also allowed the state to seize control of printing plants and equipment of the Communist and Social Democratic parties, which were often turned over directly to the Nazi Party. In the following months, the Nazis established control or exerted influence over independent press organs. During the first weeks of 1933, the Nazi regime deployed the radio press and newsreels to stoke fears of a pending communist uprising. Then they channeled popular anxieties into political measures that eradicated civil liberties and democracy. In other words, they put fear into the minds of their people in order to get laws accomplished and passed to move censorship up on the ladder of what he was trying to accomplish. It goes on that SA stormtroopers and members of the Nazi elite paramilitary formation, the SS, took to the streets to brutalize or arrest political opponents and incarcerate them in hasty establishment detention centers and concentration camps. Nazi thugs broke into opposing political party offices, destroying printing presses and newspapers, sometimes using holding companies to disguise new ownership executives of the Nazi party-owned publishing house, Franz Ehr, established a huge empire that drove out competition and purchased newspapers at below market prices. Some independent newspapers, particularly conservative newspapers and non-political illustrated weeklies, accommodated to the regime through self-censorship, keyword, or initiative in dealing with approved topics. It goes on under toward the end of World War II, of the 4,700 newspapers published in Germany when the Nazis took power in 1933, no more than 1,100 remained, and approximately half were still in the hands of private or institutionalized owners, but these newspapers operated in strict compliance with government press laws and published material only in accordance with directives issued by the Ministry of Propaganda. Wow, there was a lot said in those couple of paragraphs, and I know it was a lot to read, but here's the thing. Did you notice something? One of the first things that Nazis did to seize control of the press was to exert their influence over all press outlets. Why would they want to do that? Because you cannot control the people unless you control the information being given to the people. It's a very powerful point. So what do they do? They threaten them with their lives. They threaten to put them in jail. They threaten to deplatform them, if you will, and to take them off from where they are if they don't conform to the Nazi political views. Same thing is happening today. While we don't have concentration camps and journalists being sent to camps, that's not happening today. Today, however, we have the internet. Something that wasn't available back then is available now. And so now we have the internet using big tech organizations like Facebook, Twitter, and Google to censor what we can and can't say. And if truth be told, power is being exerted by these tech giants, who I believe there is somebody else pushing the tech giants to do this. It's not just the tech giants alone. Some shadow government force, New World Order narrative, is pushing them to do this. It started, the same exact thing started on the television. I've played clips of directors on here admitting that they had to self-censor, a word that you heard in the report a moment ago, in order to stay online and stay on the television broadcast. Well, exactly what they've done on TV, they are now exerting over the internet via control. And yes, journalists have gone to jail for some of their beliefs, Dinesta D'Souza being one here in America, as well as Tommy Robinson, who was arrested abroad for whatever reason they wanted to pin on them. But bottom line, we are being censored. Our freedom of speech is being censored online, and we're getting strong-armed. Here's the similarity specifically that I want to make is, first and foremost, back in Hitler's time, and I'm just going to reference my notes, but back in Hitler's time, if you didn't follow his regime, you were labeled a sympathizer. You were sympathizer, and you weren't racially pure, but you sympathizer. And if you were a sympathizer, you were deplatformed, sent to a concentration camp, your jobs were taken away. You would have been, had they had the internet, silenced from the internet. Today, instead of you being labeled a sympathizer, you are now labeled a racist and a hate and a bigot. If you go against the Nazi regime, you were labeled a sympathizer. If you go against the democratic socialist regime, you're labeled a hate monger and a racist. It is the same thing, just a little bit of a different package. Same concept, same ideals being presented, different ideas, obviously, but the same concept is happening all over again. We are repeating 1933, less the concentration camps, at least at this time. But obviously there are FEMA camps and things like that, but they're not being utilized at this time. But socialists, the democratic socialists, have recruited big tech to silence the masses, to silence us. And recently, some of their latest examples, we know PayPal has just removed and banned Tommy Robinson. They did that with Laura Southern, InfoWars, and many other people. Freedom Thought Project was removed off Facebook. InfoWars removed off Facebook. And the numbers are counting in the hundreds, almost going to 1,000 now, of groups that they have removed for a political view. There is something going on that cannot be ignored, and I'm trying to simplify it. Here's a second similarity. Journalists are now self-censoring. Self-censorship. What do I mean by that? I mean by, if we come online, we feel like we can't talk about certain things. If we're anti-illegal immigration, we feel like we almost can't talk about that. And some people don't anymore. If we're pro-life or whatever the case may be, we feel like we can't talk about that. We censor ourselves in order to not get in trouble by those listening in, because if we have a political view of some sort that goes against the flow, well, we don't want our platforms taken away. This is unfortunately what is happening among journalists all over America. And this is why MSN, ABC, CNN, and the rest of them have given in, and not only self-censored, but they've given in 100% and sold themselves to the devil, if you will, sold themselves to censorship. And now big tech organizations are following suit. Same tactics used in Germany. Different package, different form being utilized today. Another similarity. Back then, Jews wear a yellow star. That's what Hitler did. Obviously, lots of racism, real racism there, unlike today, right? But that's what he did. Today, we have not been labeled with a yellow star, but we have been labeled by organizations like Facebook with a score, with a number, and not just a number, but I would call it an I mark. If you so much as get the label that you're a conservative or a nationalist or even pro-Trump, then you've automatically received that check mark by Facebook, by Twitter, by Google, by PayPal, and you've been labeled as a racist. You've been labeled as the enemy. We don't have yellow stars today or any physical markings. We have an eye mark. We've been marked by social media as those they want to take down. This is the same thing Hitler did. He formed lists of journalists that spoke against his regime, formed lists of people who shared political views. He hastened all the information, quieted it all down. Nobody was allowed to speak their mind or what they really thought, or they would risk a concentration camp. In our day, we don't risk that yet. Hopefully never, I don't know, but right now we do risk the ability to speak online. And threats from groups like Antifa and other Soros-funded organizations. Well, another similarity that we've ran into today is the fact that newspapers were told what they could and couldn't say. Today, it takes the form in a Google search engine. Search engines are told what to put at the top and what not to put at the top, what to put hundreds of pages back and what to push forward on the very top. I'll give you an example. We're gonna go to the Google Chrome search engine. I'm gonna plug in the words similarities between Hitler press and what's happening in the US. Notice what has just come up. It's how it's not wrong to compare Trump and the Holocaust. Trump-Hitler comparison too easy to ignore. A leading Holocaust history compares the United States to Nazi Germany. Bang, 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 bang. I see a theme here. There's not differences of opinions coming up in the very beginning, no. It's all a propagandized narrative. They want you to believe that Trump is Hitler. Completely fabricated and untrue. But instead of actually bringing up censorship and what's happening with the freedom of press, it brought up Trump being a Nazi, Trump being evil. So I think the propaganda message that's being portrayed there is Trump is a bad guy. And pretty much that's the idea that I'm trying to get to the public, is it's a controlled narrative that they are pushing through, and very, very much so. And again, their strings are being pulled by the shadow government. And you know what? Google has admitted they're not for free speech. Check out this article from Infowars.com. Google admits in court documents that free speech is disastrous for society. Free speech is not disastrous. Free speech is what makes us American. Let me show you one last report and I'll close it with this, but Freedom House is an organization. I'm going to toss their website up on the screen, but it's a group that monitors internet freedom across the globe. And today they are sounding the alarm. You can see right there, we're growing less free around the world, and democracy itself is withering. And if you go, they have like yearly reports that they do every year. Here's a just the front of their 2008 report, and it starts with the rise of digital authoritarianism. It states governments around the world are tightening control over citizens' data and using claims of fake news to suppress dissidents, eroding trust in the internet as well as the foundations of democracy. I couldn't have said it better myself. They are eradicating free speech. And I am trying to warn the world with everything I got. I don't know how long freedom of speech will be, but let me put it this way. Freedom of speech will affect one side and the other. It may start with only one side, but guarantee you, if you're a left, if you're a Democrat, it will eventually hit you too. Everyone will be censored in some way, shape, or form. So it's either freedom or not. in the end, make your voices heard. Contact your senators, contact your congressmen, contact those outlets who are constantly censoring people. Let them know how you feel and start getting off of Facebook and Twitter. I'm not going to share the links in my description box anymore. Quite frankly, I'm slowly getting off of Facebook. I'm migrating over to Minds.com or Mayway. I've got things in both. But I no longer want to continue to have my life at stake and form a social credit for me on organizations like Facebook, who are driven by greed and corruption of the shadow government. I'm so tired of it. Anyhow, I'd love to get your thoughts, comments, and concerns. Sorry if I went a little over, but I love you guys, and please subscribe to my backup channel. I also have a channel on BitChute as well as Real.Video or Brighton Now. You can check those out below. Well, I'm Lisa Haven, signing out.